To access components that are inside the PC, you will need to remove the access panel. To remove the access panel, first remove the Torx head screw for the panel at the rear of the PC. Brace the bottom of the unit on the table and firmly slide the panel forward to disengage it from the PC. Lift the panel off of the PC. The access panel has two tabs on each inside edge of the panel. That slide into slots on the chassis. The panel also has a locking loop that slides into a slot on the rear of the chassis. To reattach the panel, align the tabs near the open ends of their slots and the locking loop under the rear lip of the PC. Slide the panel to the rear of the unit until the rear edge of the panel is flush against the rear of the chassis. Replace the Torx head screw to secure the access panel to the unit. To remove the speaker, first remove the access panel. Detach the speaker connector to the motherboard. Pull out the small plastic pin at the corner of the speaker bracket using fingernails or other fine flathead tool. Slide the speaker up and remove it from the unit. There is a small hole on the speaker for the pin that aligns with a small hole on the bracket inside the unit that holds the speaker. There are also guides on the speaker bracket for the speaker. To replace the speaker, slide the speaker into its guides on the bracket until the pinholes align. Replace the small plastic pin into the pinholes. Replace the speaker connector to the motherboard. To replace system memory, first remove the access panel. Next, gently pull out on the retaining lever located on each side of the SODIMM memory module. The module will pop up from its socket. Pull the module out of the socket. There is a small notch on one side of each SODIMM memory module that aligns over a small tab in each SODIMM socket on the motherboard. To replace an SODIMM memory module, angle the module to about 30 degrees, engaging the notch into its socket tab. Press the module down into place until the retaining levers snap into position over the sides of the module. To remove the 2.5-inch hard drive, first remove the access panel. Grasp the green pull tab on the combined power and data connector to disconnect the connector from the hard drive. Pull out on the metal release latch at the side of the drive cage while sliding the drive towards the rear of the PC. Lift the drive out of the drive cage and remove it from the unit. To install a new hard drive, detach the four Torx head shock-mounted screws from the old drive, two on each side, and install them on the new hard drive. The four side screws on the hard drive align into four slots on the hard drive cage. To install the hard drive, pull out on the retaining latch, then align the side screws into their slots on the drive cage. Slide the drive forward until the retaining latch locks the drive into place. Reattach the combined power and data connector to the drive. To remove the hard drive cage, first remove the access panel and the hard drive. Detach the three long Torx head screws that secure the cage to the motherboard. Pull the cage out of the unit, carefully clearing the drive cable from its cutout. To replace the hard drive cage, carefully feed the drive cable through its cutout and place the cage over its standoffs on the motherboard. Secure the hard drive cage to the motherboard with its three long Torx head screws. To remove the hard drive cable, first remove the access panel, the hard drive, and the hard drive cage. Note, as part of the hard drive removal procedure, the cable will be disconnected from the hard drive. Be sure to grasp the green pull tab of the cable to disconnect the cable from the hard drive. Flip up the latch for the hard drive connector on the motherboard and pull the connector out of its motherboard port. To replace the hard drive cable, insert the ribbon end of the hard drive cable into its motherboard port and secure it with its latch. The cable is reconnected to the hard drive after replacing the hard drive cage and the hard drive. To remove the heatsink fan, first remove the access panel. Detach the heatsink fan connector from the motherboard. Loosen the two captured Torx head screws for the fan. Pull the heatsink fan out of the unit. To replace the heatsink fan, align the screws of the fan over their screw holes on the thermal module. Tighten the two captured Torx head screws for the fan. Replace the fan connector to the motherboard. To remove the thermal module, first remove the access panel and the heatsink fan. Loosen the four captured Torx head screws for the thermal module in the order indicated by the stencils on the module. Pull the thermal module out of the unit. Before replacing the thermal module into the system, first, clean off the old thermal grease from the microprocessor. Clean the grease from the thermal module as well. Apply new thermal grease or a thermal pad to the microprocessor. Align the four screws of the thermal module over the four screw holes on the motherboard. Tighten the four Torx head screws in the order stenciled on the module to secure the thermal module in the system. To remove the wireless LAN board, first remove the access panel. Carefully snap off the antenna connectors from the wireless LAN board. Detach the Phillips number 1 screw, securing the wireless LAN board in place. The board will pop up. Remove the board. The wireless LAN board has a notch near one of the side edges that aligns over a key in its motherboard socket. To replace the wireless LAN board, angle the board into its motherboard socket at a 30-degree angle and press down. Hold it down while replacing the screw. Replace the antenna connectors to the board. The antenna connectors are labeled 1 and 2 and should be connected to the corresponding 1 and 2 labeled ports on the wireless LAN board. To remove the wireless LAN antennas, first remove the access panel, the hard drive, the hard drive cage, the system fan, and the thermal module. Carefully snap off the antenna connectors from the wireless LAN board. Remove the motherboard assembly from the unit. Untape the front wireless antenna cable from the bottom of the chassis. There is a hooked tab securing the front antenna to the chassis. Press down on the tab to release the antenna and pull the antenna cable out the front of the unit. Loosen the bits of conductive tape that help secure the rear antenna to the bottom of the chassis. Remove the rear antenna from its cable guides on the bottom of the chassis. Remove the rear antenna cover by squeezing on the top tab, securing the cover, and releasing the cover. There is a hooked tab securing the rear wireless antenna to the chassis. Press down on the tab to release the antenna and pull the antenna cable out through its access hole at the rear of the unit. The rear antenna has a hooked tab and two small locator pins that fit over an edge and into two small holes on the unit. To replace the rear antenna, feed the antenna cable back in through its access hole. Then press the hooked tab and pins into place. The cover for the rear antenna has a hooked tab at the top and the bottom edges that fit into small slots on the rear of the unit. There are also three pins on the rear antenna cover. For correct alignment upon replacement, the end with two of the pins should be on top. To replace the rear antenna cover, hook the bottom tab into its slot, then press the top tab into place. Replace the rear antenna into its cable guides on the bottom of the unit. And tape it down with its conductive tape. The front antenna also has a hooked tab and two locator pins that fit over an edge and into two small holes on the front of the unit. To replace the front antenna, feed the antenna cable back in through its access hole, then press the hooked tab and pins into place. Secure the front antenna to the bottom of the chassis with its tape. replace the motherboard assembly into the unit. Replace the antenna connectors to the board. The antenna connectors are labeled 1 and 2 and should be connected to the corresponding 1 and 2 labeled ports on the wireless LAN board. CMOS factory settings should be restored as a first step before replacing the system motherboard. To restore CMOS factory settings, first remove the access panel and the hard drive. Remove the battery from the motherboard. Wait 30 seconds. Replace the battery to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings are now reset. Note that you will now need to enter system BIOS and reset the clock in BIOS after this procedure. To remove the motherboard, first remove the access panel, the hard drive, the hard drive cage, and hard drive cable, the wireless LAN board, system memory, the heatsink fan, and the thermal module. Detach the speaker connector from the motherboard. Detach the four Torx head screws that secure the motherboard to the chassis. Tip up the front edge of the motherboard and remove the motherboard from the unit. Place the motherboard in an anti-static bag. To install a new motherboard, tip the back edge connectors of the motherboard into their ports on the chassis, being careful of the wireless LAN antenna cables, and lay the motherboard into place. Secure the motherboard to the chassis with four Torx head screws. Replace the speaker connector to the motherboard.